Hello everybody and welcome to Forever Stranded. At the end of the last episode, I had basically did a bit of Better With Mods and produced the Soul Urn. Well, since then I've produced a few more Soul Urns, and today I'd like to build the anvil, because what I want to do is make a block dispenser. But first I'm going to do something slightly different, because I also need a bit more immersive engineering stuff. So today I'm going to build the press, I think, to start with. So let's get on with that. And I think I'm going to put it down over here. I've got everything with me I need. I think I'm going to just do it between around about here, I think, in front of these. Somewhere like this would be good. So the recipe for this is fairly straightforward. Let's have a look. I need some scaffolding to start with. Let's put some scaffolding down here. So we need two blocks of scaffolding, one there and one there. In the middle of that goes the redstone engineering block. And then we need a piston going facing down. It doesn't matter, I'll put it just anywhere. And then I'll take the engineer's hammer and right click it till it faces down like that. Then we need two conveyor belts, and they both need to face in the same direction. So we'll get them going like that and like that. And then on top of these, we need a heavy engineering block. So I'll jump up there like that and put this up here. Oops, I can't get on it, can I? Try again. Yeah, it tries to push me off all the time. I'll tell you what I'll do it from. Just do it like that. Good. And all I need to do now is right click this with the hammer, and then it forms the press. So that's just fine. And power goes in from the top. Let's have a look over here if I can see the if there's a yes, there is an input in there, isn't there? I'm not sure if I have to do it with a connector or not. Let's see if that works or not. So let's get out of here. I don't need that. I want in here. I've got some cables and some connectors. I've only got two left. I don't like spending all my time cutting these up. That's why I wanted to make the press. So let's right click this one to start with and see if that will link into here. I'll start on this. Oops, I can't reach, can I? Maybe I'll have to put something down. So look, what have I got with me I can put down? I've got a chest, I suppose. I could put that down, couldn't I? So I can reach that. Still can't reach that. It's a bit high. Right, there we go. Now, let's see if I can connect that to there. No, it doesn't seem to want to connect directly. So let's get out a connector. Put that on. I think I just need to right click that. I have to shift right click it down. Now I'm too far, too close. Let's go back. Still too close. More of a challenge than I thought it was going to be. Never mind. Let's have a look. What else can I do? I'll have to get something else to do this. I could use a scaffolding. I've got some steel scaffolding here. Let's do that first. I wonder if this works like the other scaffolding. So if I right, left click it, no. Can I climb up it? Yes, I can, good. So now I can reach quite happily. So we should be able to bring this down. Let's see if that actually does connect or it needs a connector. No, it doesn't want that, so it needs a connector. So now it's got its connector and now it's linked. So that'll give it some power. I think it's got enough power. I wonder if these break like the other scaffolding does. Where's my pickaxe? No, it doesn't. Right, so that's prepared, and what I need to do now is make a press for cables. Don't have to do that. Let's have a quick look at doing that. Oh, look here. My ender pearls have now filled up the end stone. So I've now got 25 of those, plus some extra ones down here. Let's have a look. 12 extra ones. That's doing pretty well. Looks like it needs some more fuel soon as well. Oh, there's something else I didn't show. Let's get rid of this stuff I've got on me at the moment. I don't want it all with me. So I can get rid of all these blocks. What else is here is from Immersive Engineering, some of these. I think some steel rods. And that's basically it. The rest I keep with me, I think. Yes, let's have a look. Put that away. and the book. I can't put the book away, I don't think, because it needs a space in the bottom bit here. Right. So what we now need to do with that, I mean, probably it must be a press. So let's have a look. And there we go. That's the one I want to make. So what do we need for that? Steel plates and a steel or copper wire, or even an electrum wire. That's fairly easy. You can make a copper wire, no problem. And some steel plates. That might be more interesting. So I need four steel plates. I wonder. What I do is here I've got a plate mould or plate cast. So I put in four steel into here. That goes into the hopper comes into here and it just basically puts them in. They'll melt. And if I turn this on, I've still got some iron in there, have I? Oh, I still got two blocks of iron. Right, let that go through. That's gonna make some more iron plates in here. So that's how I do those. And I don't know whether that works with steel. Some of the stuff does, some of the stuff doesn't work. If it doesn't work, I'll have to do it the other way with the hammer. But then you get damage on your hammer, so I don't want to do it that way. What else do we have to do? A cable, didn't we? So a piece of copper, which we need to hammer, which I've got already. Let's have a look in here. 54 copper plates, so I just need a pair of those and a pair of shears or cutters. Cutters are cheaper because they don't wear. Well, there's only one piece of iron in cutters. Here we go, engineering wire cutters. Let's have a look at that. And I just do this and this, and it should make the copper coil great. See, as I use them, they take damage, which I don't like really, because they damage quite quickly. Can I put those in there? Oh, if it kind of goes into tools, great. So what else is there? Just the steel ones. Okay, let's go and get this. That works for steel as well. Should have smelted by now. 18. Yeah, steel smelted. Let's see if that actually put that at the bottom. See if that actually works. Three ingots, two ingots. Ah, it looks like it is working great. Because the smelter is a great way. You can do not just the standard stuff like the standard tools, but you can also do gears and ingots and nuggets as well. That should be the four. Good. So I can now make this press. So it is just a copper coil plus in the plus shape of these, and we get a metal moulding wire. I wonder how I use this. We'll take some copper with this as well. About three, that'll be a start. So it should go on here, shouldn't it? Let's see if it works. So I right click that. Oh yes, it does. So now what do I have to do? Put down copper ingots on here. Let's try pressing Q on it, see if that works. Oh yeah, that goes on there. And sure enough, that's got pressed. And the other one's disappeared, so where did that go to? Oh, I've got it back in my inventory. So I presume I can right click. No, I can't right click it on there, so I can try Q again. It just didn't work. Still wants to put that there. Let's come to this side. Tell you what, we'll do remove these electrum ingots and leave those in there so I can get the copper one back in here if I can't. Maybe the magnet's the problem. Let's turn the magnet off. There we go. Of course, these will have dropped off, gets pressed, and it'll fall off the end and it'll get picked up in my. What do we got? Four. So it does two each ingot. That's great. You get double usage for that as well. Right, so what I've got in here is really noisy, just this bit. I've got an unfired urn. Let's go and it's night time, so it's not a good time to do this. But I haven't got any more ground netherrack. I've got 47 in here. We'll leave that for the time being. But what I want to do is I want to use the salt urns I've made to make some salt. There we got some salt urns in here, three of those. Actually, I want to make this salt. Soulforged steel. That's fairly straightforward, actually. It's just iron and an urn. What else is in there? I think that might be about it. Let's have a look. Whoops, I pressed R and sorted it. And that's the recipe for that one. So, in the stroke cauldron, oh, we need some coal dust. Okay, good. So, I've got plenty of coal dust in here. Let's just take three. Oops, I can't put it back in again. Actually, I'm going to put it in here. Because I want to make some more dark steel. Actually, what do I want? Three. That's dark steel. That's in here. One, three, yeah. So we just put this into the stroked cauldron. And that's this blue one. Well, the one under the flames here. So all you have to do is to put these three soul urns in here. Three of these and three iron. Like that. And that starts the process. Got these nice blue flames. And when it reaches the top, we get a soul forged steel coming out. And we get the urn back again. So it now becomes just a standard urn. We'll let that do that. Because what I want to do next is to make the anvil from Better With Mods. The reason we want to make the anvil is you can't make anything else without it. So let's have a look. You can actually do it like this if you don't. If it's a mod name's got spaces and you can take the spaces out. Feel. So it's just this one like that. We should be able to just make one of these and put that down somewhere. Actually, I've got an anvil in here which I don't tend to use that much. Let's just break this one out and put this one in its place. And here we get a 4x4 matrix. And what I want to do is I want to make a block dispenser. So let's have a look what we've got to do for that. In fact, I've got a horrible feeling I need some sort of some ordinary soul urn, soul forged urns and that, and I've just used them all up, which wasn't very clever. So let's go and get some netherite ground. We need two, so that means we need 32. Should have 48 by now, so that'll make three, so yep. Let's put them in the mill and get out of the way until they've been done. Dreadful. And then I need some filtered hoppers, so make sure I've got some filtered hoppers as well. How many filtered hoppers have I got in here? Probably I've got 12. I only don't need any more. And that, I just need some soul sand. Let me just sort my inventory again because it's a bit full. And let's put some stuff away as well. I've got in here some space for some tools. I'll put that back, and in the iron backpack we'll put in the other ones over here. Looks fairly full, doesn't it? I will get rid of the eggs and the feathers. We got steel, good. I'll put the steel in here because we don't need that for the time being. But what we do need is this. I want to have a look at this recipe for a block dispenser, and it's this device here. And you'll see it's made in that. So we need some. Oh, we need some moss stone as well. Okay, I've got vines, which will make one. So we need four, wasn't it? No, six. Six cobblestone, isn't it? Yeah, double check it again. Yeah, six cobblestone. Let's just go in here. Just pick out six cobblestone from in here. And we need some six vines. Now I've got some shears. Hopefully in here. Yes, I've got some dark shears. Empowered. So they basically shear a great big lump of stuff in one go. And if you haven't seen these before, these are immersive engineering powered lanterns. And they prevent mobs spawning in a 32 block radius. Which is pretty good. Now where's my jungle trees down here? got plenty of vines on it, hasn't it? So let's just... Right, click those and turn the magnet back on again. Good. And there's a few bits up there, it'll spread. Okay, netherrack's still grinding. Oh, yeah, that's my fish farm. I'll show you that next time, I think. So what do we need? We needed six of these, didn't we? So we just need six of those. I think it's even sheared some jungle leaves off too. Which I don't really need. Let's put the rest of the stuff in here. For the time being. So what else was we need? Some smooth stone, didn't we? Six again, is it? Or is it eight? Oh, just four. That's no problem. These are the ones which are going to be a bit of a problem. Let's have a look. Is it still night time? No, it's coming to morning. Hopefully I've got 32 of these now. 21. Deal with these spiders. See that XP piece of XP over there? There's some spider eye. You can right click that as well, and this should actually pick a tool up and bring it back to you. I've got the spider eye, which is quite a good trick actually. I didn't realise you could do that. Just by chance, I found it out. So I'll get one of these soul urns made, I think. But this is quite dangerous. So put that down there. Oh, I think I haven't got any... I haven't, have I? I've been a bit daft. What I haven't got is I haven't got any soul sand. I'll have to quickly go back and get some soul sand. Right, I'll come back when I've done that. Right, I'm back with some soul sand. Let's have a look. Right, click this, put the soul sand in here. And then I'm now going to get my inventory organised. So I've got my bow in my hand, almost ready anyway. So let's stand just about on top of this and get right click this to about, oops, got to press Q, haven't I? About 16 times. There she is. Oh, look. One. I should have eaten actually before I started that. Let's just do that now. Now my food's empty. So let's do that one more time. I should be okay, I think. So what do I want to do? I need to put the hopper down first of all, don't I? And I've got to, I went back and got some more ground netherrack as well. So let's just put this down back down here again. Put it on top of it. Put the soul sand into that again. You don't lose the soul sand when it breaks, it comes back to you. So a little bit, just to get this going again. Should be about eight. That time we didn't get a ghast. It seems that you get less ghast when you're actually standing on top of it. So anyway, I've got my two soul urns now. Zombie, and you'll see here I got these two urns back and some more soul forged steel. So that's how you get your soul forged steel. But let's come back in here now. So I prepared all this. The only thing I needed now were these two soul forged urns, and then get this block dispenser. What I'm hoping for is that I can actually put this down. Let's have a look. What I want to do is I want to put this down near to the sawmill. So I'll put it down, say, here. I'm hoping that I can put wood into this I've never used it. First time I've ever made it, even, so I don't exactly know. Let's go and get some wood. Oh, that's the end marker for the range of the actual additions or atomic reconstructor. Let's take a stack of that. Oh, I'm a bit full of my inventory. Actually, I've already picked up two stacks, didn't I? Let's put a couple of these in. See what happens. Does this need a pulse? Does it need a redstone signal? Let's try putting a red... Oh, it does need a redstone signal. I get it. So therefore, this would work well with a turntable and a timer. Or a button. So look, have I got a button with me? Probably not, I guess. Let's quickly make a button. In fact, I'll put this other anvil in here as well. I've got, see, I've got two. I'll use this one for making the flat transfer nodes. Smooth stone should be in here. Let's take one of those and make a button. And you hear the chimes tinkling away. That basically means the windmill would break. But the watermill works just fine. Let's put it on there. And there's also a block detector in this as well. I'm just wondering if we can use a block detector. Let's have a look. Better with mods has a block detector. And I think that gives a redstone signal when there's a block in its path. Let's see how we make that. Now, which one is it? This one? Detector blocks. Okay, that's not too difficult. It says polished lapis. Oh, wow. Okay, that's an interesting recipe. Six lapis, three gold nuggets, and I've got no inventory space. Let's put the ground netherrack away here in the urns. I'm going to put my enderite stuff in this chest up here, because it's where I keep the enderite stuff, basically. And I'll put that up there as well. Try to remember where I put everything. I've got some sulfur that just stays in here, and some nitrate too. And in here I've got actually nothing with me in here. So I've got some bits and pieces. Yeah, these. Some slabs. In fact, I'll keep the hellfire dust here. I should have 32. Did I lose one? Maybe I did. Right, that looks a bit better now. So what do we need? Some smooth stone and some cobblestone, is it? Let's have a quick look. Four cobblestone. Four redstone, which of course I've put away in there. So we want four cobblestone, four smooth stone, four redstone. Redstone torches. Oh, yes, that's right. We need some more of that. We need some gold nuggets I've got in there, I think, and six lapis. Did that make one or two? Yeah, I thought it made two. Right. So, gold nuggets, three, and one redstone. Yes, three. Okay. That was just a mouse scroll on there. Maybe I should move this to a better place. Huh? So, they go like this, if I remember rightly. Three nuggets. Good. Two polished lapis. So then... block detector. They go like that, I think. No, they go down the side, don't they? And I think it was redstone torches, wasn't it, the last one? Yes, two redstone torches. I got the redstone, I didn't pick up the sticks, that's all. And I will take some more redstone with me as well when we go and do that. So wonder did block detector with from better with mods. So let's have a look. Let's just take a bit of redstone with us and see if this works. Tell you what we'll do, we'll put this down first of all, and then which is the front? I guess the one with the eyes. So let's put here some redstone. Like that, and then let's put a block in front of it. Do I have that wood, or did I leave that in the chest? I don't know. I only basically want a block, don't I? Put that in that one. So what happens if I put a block down here? Yes. So you do get a redstone signal when the block's in front of it. Great. So what I now need is a pickaxe to pick all of this up. And I've got any of this in the engineer's toolbox, of course. I shall keep that there. I should set up some rules for doing that as well with the one that wants the flinty. So break that. And the piece of wood. So I reckon if I put in here the block detector, it does face this way. Yep. And then bring some redstone signal around. Some redstone around here. Take it from the button. And then put some. What do I want to do? There's no block in there. Therefore, this wants to have a redstone signal. Okay. So we just basically need another block. With a redstone torch on it. So I just need the redstone torch. Otherwise I'll have to use a turntable. Oops, that wants to be on there. On there. That's interesting. Because it's getting stuck, it can't get into the chest. So what we'll do is we'll remove this out of here a bit and bring it further along. Want that back and that back. So I put the redstone torch on here and then bring this around. And that's detecting a block. I don't see what block it's detecting, mind you. Actually, like that'll do, won't it? Yeah, that turns it off. So it says it's got orange, pinky eyes. It says there's a block in here. Don't see any blocks in here, do you? Strange. Oh, I removed the button, didn't I? So change this. Okay, I'm gonna have to do this with a turntable. But that was the idea. But it says there's a block to be detected. I don't think you've got any interface on this, have we? No. Okay. I'll go and figure that one out and come back. when I've done it. I think that's it for this episode, actually. I hope you've enjoyed it. So next time, with a bit of luck, I'll do something more else with better with mods. And I should show you the fish as well. And I want to make some diamond tools. So until then, bye for now.